Hey there, buddies. I'm Paul Roberts, RT1. It's been raining. You can hear it way in the upper parts of the cave.
I thought it never rained here.
Fortunately, it's nice and dry in here, and it's somewhat warm. 60 degrees. Yay. Gosh, I don't know what I'm gonna do next. But I'm not gonna show you everything I do, so I might as well just show you some things I do for fun to inspire. It's really best to not do it about cast parts, because everybody else is gonna use cast parts. On eBay, some people are using my stuff. Hey, imitation is a sincerest form of flattery, right? So let's show you how to make something out of non-cast parts and make it your own. Now you could do this. I've seen people do it with cowls, cut different shapes and glue it together. I've seen people do it with muscle, armor suit type things. I could show you how to do that, but it's not cost effective, and I want to do something simple that I can afford the time to do. That's one of the reasons why I'm doing what I'm doing. I can stay connected. You might learn something, or you might just spend some time with me. I feel like when I'm doing it, I'm spending time with you. Maybe you can feel like you're spending some time with me. Let's go over to the table and take a look at some of the things I have laid out, talk about what I'm gonna do with them. All right, so we have a bunch of stuff, probably too much for one belt, and some of it probably won't work very well, but I'm gonna go over it with you. Maybe I'll just select the best and save some for next time. All right, so you have, make sure it's junk, it's gotta be junk. It doesn't have to be junk, you can make it anything you want. But for these videos, I am emphasizing the fact of what you can do with junk. This is a foam nail polish holder inside of a box. I have a magnifying glass and a broken calculator with a thing that can be Velcroed on or stuck onto a belt. Maybe an idea of a bungee cord thing to hold it on and these to hold it in place so it doesn't go wonky. It won't look good if it does that. Some kind of IKEA business card holders I picked up at a convention downtown. They're made out of wood. Hey, they look like belt pouches to me. We have this survival mirror, and I've bent it slightly. Have this OtterBox. I don't know, maybe I'll try it. I'll have that lined up there. So if you look at it from a side, it'll look like something, but I have to keep that curve going. So I'll either have to glue it down to make sure it stays in place, or put this underneath it, or something like that. I'm not sure. Just suggestions right now. I'm thinking to myself as I go along. This has to come off. This is too big and bulky, but this is kind of cool. This could like attach underneath this. It's one of those things where you can clip a phone onto a vent in a car or something like that. I thought it'd be cool to hold the batarang. So that could go on the bottom of that. This is a case, and it, right now the stuff in it looks like junk, and even you can see that stupid little just stuff. You know, maybe you can have a semi-transparent thing. Obviously, we don't want those things showing. We don't want the blue. But it just looks like something's going on in there. So as long as it's transparent, opens up really nicely, might as well exploit that fact. Who knows what those things are? So we have some Velcro. I've got these left over from other projects. Basically, I'm just gonna put Velcro on these. Of course, we're gonna change the colors and everything too. So that's there for my notes. This is really cool. I've been waiting for this to die on my wife. We tried to replace it. It used to work. She would make creme brulee. Really cool. But it's a great Batman torch. Yeah, it's mine finally because it doesn't work. And she's buying another one. So, all right. So I'm going to make some kind of a thing here. Masters of Taste. Oh, nice. Yeah, we're Masters of Taste here, aren't we, guys? We're into Batman costuming. No, we'll make that go away. It doesn't go down in far enough. So I'll probably slip the bottom of this a little bit so that it'll go down in all the way. And I've got various other little things with the right, you know, doodads can make it look like something with the right painting. Got a couple little tire valves here. These little see-through window things. And then I've always got these other projects that I can make if they need to go in between or whatever. I've got this really cool thing with this great texture. I haven't used it yet, but it's there in case I need it. So what am I gonna do? Got to use scraps. I'm not gonna go and spend money on this stuff. I've got enough brown here for the front part, or I can make an extra long one that goes around. I have a clipping mechanism, but this would be too small for me. So I would cut it and make it further apart so that it's larger. And then I thought, well, since I've got that, maybe there's an element underneath here. I don't know, a dual belt. I don't want to show too much of the belt. I could get more on it. Because once it bends, you've got like space in between the things. And so I'm gonna probably put things pretty tight together. So I'm not exactly sure what I'm gonna do, but I'm not gonna sit here and run this glue gun and glue this stuff together and run my Zappa Gap and all that, because that gets boring. So what I'm gonna do, it's just spend some time on this, hopefully making it quick. I thought this was kind of cool. A little lighter inside there. I'll probably shove that down into there. You know, hey, it's a thing, you know? It looks like something. You don't want it to be blue like that, but sometimes you take little doodads and you add them on. You know, this is from a bike mirror or something like that. You just add it on somehow. It makes it look like it does something, you know?
always like to add to the thing, you know, so that it looks like, oh, that's not what you think it is. It's something else. You know, I don't know what it is exactly. Maybe I'll cut that and put it in the front. I don't know. But you want to take it a little further away from what it is. Well, this is really cool. I wished it worked. I tried the batteries, but boy, that looks really cool. I mean, what does that do? I don't know. Something Batman would do. It even almost has bat ears sticking up. Almost. So I'll just stick that on there. So this is the start. Oh, mail call. Yes, this is the man that used to live and work in this space that I'm in right now. He used to have a really nice harp fix-it place. Harp, maybe piano, harp. Still getting his mail. Finding out what could be causing your hearing loss is as easy as 1, 2, 3. Oh, that's not good. If he had hearing loss, how is he going to work on those harps? Well, I guess he can still put them together, maybe not tune them. Anyway, let's get started, folks. Let's go ahead and start attaching this, making it work. And I'll do the painting at the last part, because that's really fast and easy. And it'll take this belt and make it look from a junk-centered belt to a Batman gizmo gadget high-tech look faster than using a glue gun is going to do. All right, bad buddies. I'll talk to you soon. Well, that was quick. Actually, this is the next day. But for you, it's just a few seconds of that signal away. All right, so here it all is. This is what I use for going up above. It's not very great, you know, but it works. I'd like to be able to do it like this so I can talk to you and I can work, but you can't see what I'm doing. My head gets in the way sometimes. Let's try something else. So let's go over this. All right, so I went ahead and did some gluing. This can come out. You could just have this like this. Or something else could go on there. This is dumb having this here. But otherwise, it looks like a calculator. So I could do other things with this. I'm not sure what. I haven't used everything. I haven't used this. I haven't used the texture. I haven't used this. Okay, so this, you know, it's a lighter. It's a high-tech lighter. Batman only cigarettes. So this is on there like that. I didn't paint it first because I wanted good adhesion. Business card holders. I like the simplistic look. I was gonna put things on there. I just felt like this belt's already clunky, a little bit larger than I would like in a lot of aspects. So I'm leaving that clean look right up front. These things are gonna wrap around, you're not gonna see them as much. So what I did was I took this and I cut it in half so it's thinner, just to have a little bit of exposed areas of shine. And then I'll make this into something that looks like it must be something. I don't know what it is yet. And this has the OtterBox clamp on the back of it. And I just put some of these other things on here to give it a feeling like I didn't cut it in half. Take this off. I got a small piece of Velcro on there. You could make these, I could put anything there. It doesn't have to be this, but it's kind of neat because this latch allows that to tighten up on this. I put this thing here and this thing here to hold it in place. Now that I've got the Velcro on there, I don't think I'm gonna lose it. And this is just, I don't know, it does something. Who knows what? But I don't like the look of it at all. I thought I had some really cool stuff, but this is a little clunkier than I really like. You know, every belt I want to be different. This will appeal to some people, not to others. Let's finish it and see if I like it better when it's done. Look at all this mess. Let's clear this up. Oh, that's better. Just hit it the way it is and give it a dusting. I just want to bring everything down. I'm going to mute it a little bit. So I don't really want to change the color completely. I just want to have a nice palette to work with. I want that red coming through. I don't want so much of that turquoise coming through. All right, it's getting more dulled down. Now what I'm gonna do is I'm not gonna go too far. I can always go farther later. I should have taken that out of there, but who cares? Not gonna solve crime this week anyway. But I do like a little bit of black clings to it because this way everything looks a little more aged, a little more uniform. I was just at Harry Potter the other day in Universal. And I love how they just, even if it's a piece of glass, everything's got like this stuff around it, you know, just to give it an aged look. I'm always looking at that kind of thing. That's one of the things I like best about some of the theme parks is see what the scenics do. I used to be a scenic. I worked at MGM. I worked at Star Scenic. I worked at Cinnabar and did the Bat Cave for Chicago Six Flags. Once I hit this a little bit, I might go in and say, okay, I don't want those numbers like that. This has to go down more without losing that stick. So what I might do is like mask it off with something. And I'll say, okay, let's get that a little bit more blackish without hitting the sticky stuff. Again, I don't want too much on that. No problem, because I'm going to brush that and I'm in it anyway. I picked up another 55-gallon drum of latex this morning, so it's the afternoon. I'm ready for what's coming up. The new year. I'm going to use a new brush so I can get a more subtle texture. I went too heavy on there, but that doesn't matter. I know I'm going to change it anyway. Slightest little amounts. This is really cool. Like, instead of attaching it to this thing, I attached it to here because the Batarang was going to get in the way of other things. And down here, it's kind of unorthodox, but why not? Do something different every time. So I'm going to let this go onto the silver a little bit. All right, already that doesn't look like just standard black foam anymore. So if I go right on that edge of that white thing, it'll get a little bit more of a gold highlight. Almost looks like metal now. All it is a piece of plastic. It doesn't want to stick to this blue, which is fine by me. Let a little bit of it come through. Every material is different. And if you don't mind that, you go in with the idea that it's going to be that way, things won't bother you as much. You'll say, let's just say this has been in the field a few times. So sometimes this will be off. And when it is off, you'll see it. It's just a hose. Hose washer is all it is. I want to be able to see through there. I don't want it to look like a cheap makeup case. A really, 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 really dry brush. Things start to show up that are there already, but now you can see them better. I'm not very talkative today. Gosh, it's been 2 whole months plus, I think, now. Yeah. Yeah, because I stopped before Halloween. Gotta get back in my same old spirit. I mean, I feel the same. I'm not coming off verbally the same. You think, what can I talk about? What's been happening? Gosh. Well, I showed you some videos of my trip. I don't know if anybody's interested in that, but, you know, I try to share with you guys because it's just my way of showing you all that, you know, I do things and like to say, hey, what do you guys think about this and that? You know, I'm a guy that feel like you know me a little bit. Go ahead and share some things. You know, I don't know exactly why. Why not, right? I guess I keep thinking, like, oh, that Love Boat thing, that one, that really short video about, I don't know, the length of the theme song. I think it's like 1,500 hits in just a couple of days. It made me realize, oh my gosh, if I wasn't doing Batman stuff to this really limited community, and I was structuring full-time doing other stuff, I could get more hits. But I'm not really into this for hits. I've got to be doing things I want to do. And kind of have a delicate mix of things that the Bat Buddies want me to do too. It's tricky. And not making any money on it. It's like only for my interest's sake. And every once in a while I show you some things that I do. But a lot of times it's the same thing over and over again. It's one of the reasons why I don't post a lot. Because I know, and I stopped posting a long time ago, because I didn't want to bore people. It's one thing when a new person gets a new costume. And it's the same costume we've seen 1,000 times. And sometimes it's new. Sometimes it's new. And even if we've seen it 1,000 times, we still like to get into his enthusiasm and say, hey, you know, that's really cool, you know. But at some point, we're doing it for the sake of the person, because we're not being fake necessarily, but it's like, how many times? Like Bryn said one time, but the only thing you can do to count on is tell him how his facial hair differs, because everything else is the same all the time, he says. I don't know, maybe he was just in a mood that day. But yeah, it gets like that. So what I try to do is I try to do something that's relevant, that I'll enjoy, that's worth the time. Like, for instance, if I was stopping the camera all the time while I was doing this gluing stuff, it would have taken me 3 times as long. And I'm saying to myself, do people have to see me gluing stuff and everything? And cutting stuff? Maybe not. So I was saying, okay, I don't want to do that. It took me about an hour, maybe more than an hour, to put this together. And then you're seeing me do this in real time, almost real time. I'll have some cuts in here. And I say to myself, I don't want to take more than 2 hours, because then I got to edit it, and that's going to take an hour or two. Here's what you got to do on something like this. You could just leave it itself, but it looked cheap, even though it was cool. Go in a lot of different directions sporadically, okay? I want to make this thing look like it's been in the field. It's got a lot more stuff going on than if you just had that cheap, straight plastic look. And then I can come back and do some finishing details. Go in here, a few areas I got too much stuff on, like this red area. Get a little more red coming through. Just a little bit in the middle part. Let's have that decayed look around the outside there. Why not? Harry Potter would have the same thing. Oh man, I was on Harry Potter the other day. I'm gonna tell you a story. It's not a very funny story. I gotta have something to talk about while I'm working here. Well, I can just barely fit in the little thing that closes down around you. And I don't like being all trapped in there. I always think to myself, what if this thing gets stuck? We have an earthquake, we have a power outage, some kind of a catastrophe, nuclear bomb going off or something. How am I going to get out of here? I say to myself, eh, I could probably work my way out. If it's high enough, I could probably work my way out somehow, like a contortionist. And I say, I feel more comfortable knowing that I could get out of that. And I like to enjoy the ride more, too. Well, apparently you have to go down 3 clicks, so they won't let you go. So it was cold the other day, and I went with my daughter and my wife, and I only put it down 2 clicks. I didn't know the 3-click rule. Because I had my sweater and my jacket and different things on, and I was much bigger than usual, and they stopped the ride. They came over to me and said, you gotta go down 3 clicks. I go, oh, I didn't know. So they walked me behind the scenes, and they started the ride up again, and they said, you can go on, it's just you need to know that, and that's what you gotta do. I said, oh, no problem. They said, why don't you take your jacket off? I was explaining to them about the jacket and everything. So I took that off, went right back on, like I normally was, and got it down the 3 clicks. Not a very great story, but interesting, right? It's different. We don't all have that happen every day. I thought it's funny. I don't know if I embarrassed my daughter or not. Sometimes I get embarrassed by the things that I do. You know, I could do something with this right here. Take that off. I don't know if I will. It already looks good. But just touching it like this gives it a different look. Once again, just the slightest little bit coming off. Gives it an extra pronunciated whatever. Let me put this in here. I'm not gonna do anything with the label right now. This is just really just to show you guys, you know, just to relate to you guys on a regular basis. This is really all this is. Everything doesn't have to be perfect. I'm not gonna wear this. I am thinking about going to Dragon Con. I've been talking with a couple of bet buddies, but there's no guarantee. And even if I went, I bet it's not the same as it used to be. I'll be so disappointed. A lot of times I like to accentuate this leather material too, with some scratches, maybe a rag. I like this a lot, so it gets a little bit dull on there. I've got Velcro on the back of this. Touch a few areas I might not have touched before as I go along, and then do the other side. So I want to go really, really hot on this calculator because it still looks like a calculator. Let's go a little bit heavier on the black, just the sides. You know, another thing too, I really should let this dry. A lot of times I scrape the black off because I haven't let it dry. I scrape it off too much. So sometimes I do things differently just to show you guys that I wouldn't normally do, like that, for instance. I wouldn't go into wet on wet right there. I'd wait till that's totally dry and then I dry brush it. But, you know, a lot of times when I do things, I'm doing it to get it done and not do a lot of cuts and come back and let time pass by. I'm just telling you these things in case you're wondering. I don't know how much you're going to try to do it like me. I hope you do it your own way. But I'm just telling you some of those things so you'll know about it. So I was thinking I'd put a little bat symbol in there, but right now I'm just gonna let it be. I toned that down a little bit, it's better. So it basically has a little bit of a gold sheen to the whole thing. Still a calculator, but make it look less like a Texas Instruments. And it's not red anymore when it blends in with the silvers and the golds. It's like a really muted red, and that's great. Why not? I see these people doing early utility belts and they're all neat and clean and everything. That's great, that's a fine look, it's a fine look. It's like if Batman has enough money that every time he goes out, he has a brand new one of everything, then that's what he would look like. Sure. But I don't personally like it. It's not much fun. Everything is always perfect all the time. So that's not the greatest thing in the world, but it's fast. So I'm going to put it back in there. Everybody's going to wonder, well, what is that? Why is that there? And that's okay. Let them wonder every once in a while. Let them wonder every once in a while. It's good for them. Heavy parts. I'll go down inside of it, and then I'll go in there with my alcohol, get a few glimmering, shimmering metal parts to come through again, and I might just have it. And we might as well do this while we're at it. This is the way I do a batarang a lot of times. I'll take and I'll scratch it up like that. And I see the edges and everything. I say, okay, let's go ahead and hit it, mute it down a little bit, and you could fool with it a little bit that way and get it to the level you want. So then the button still works. That still goes in there. Boom, I'm ready to go. And sometimes you can even spray it a little bit on the edge too. So it just hits the edge. Let's look at it from the top. One more thing of black, a little bit more gold. And then again, the alcohol doesn't hurt this. I could come in and make some scrapes and stuff too, but I'm not gonna. Just tone that down a little bit. Oh yeah, IKEA, that's great. Isn't that great? The first thing you're gonna see is Batman shots at IKEA. You ever get stuck in IKEA and try to get out? It's like a maze. Man, I still gotta figure it out every single time I go. Well, let's try that on and see how it feels. Wait a minute. I gotta have more of a a glint to that. That's sticking up too far to not have a glint. I wish I had something to put in there. Oh, I know what I was gonna do. I was gonna go in there and make a few of those silver areas come out again. So what's gonna happen is the silver is gonna shine way more than the area around it. And you're gonna say, whoa. Whoa. That's when you're gonna see the different artifacting, and some of it's gonna shine more. What I wanna do at this point is do a little hand working to make that a little more arbitrary. I would have loved it if I had something to put in here. And you could take them out, and when you take them out, you see that there's areas where they've rubbed up against the metal so much they've made it polished. A little diagonal, maybe a couple of scratches every now and then. Maybe this can use a few areas where it's been nicked. That's not perfect. If you make things not perfect, then what happens is people don't look for problems. Because they say, oh, it's all part of the general look, that it's all at the same level. And then it's okay. Let's try that on. I like it. Couple hours of work. A little bit of Zappa Gap, hot glue, alcohol, spray paint, a couple rags, paint brushes, a couple scissors, things to cut with, maybe a little Dremel to cut things off, and there you go. On the back, I just didn't use these belts after all. I'll use them for something else. I had enough brown to go all the way around, so I just went with that look. So it's just the same thickness all the way around. I like it. And again, this is just what I do. I had fun over a period of a couple of days. I think it added up to about 2.5 hours maybe. That's longer than I'd like to take. But hey, it's really nothing. You can do it in an evening, guys. Save up some stuff, put it together. Just proving you can do it. It's okay for a couple hours of work. I'm happy with it. Why not? A couple hours work, and you got something. I'd love to see what you guys are working on. Talk to me. Talk to you later, Bat Buddies. I'm Paul Roberts, RT1.